In England, Kenneth Alford is generally regarded as their march king, and rightfully so. He wrote over 20 of the world's greatest marches. Actually, however, his real name was Freddie Ricketts. I suppose that may explain why he chose to use a pen name. However, in this country, about the same time, the first 30 years of the last century, was a composer and arranger whose name was Harry Alford, which was his real name. Harry set up an arranging company in the Chicago area, probably the first musician to consider making a full-time living as an arranger. He had a large staff of arrangers and copyists and a suite of offices that took up studios almost the entire floor of the big State Lake Theater downtown. He arranged music for vaudeville, circuses, musical theater, dance bands, early radio commercials, musical shows. But in addition, he was a much sought-after ghostwriter, where musicians of all sorts would come into his office and hand him a few bars of a melodic idea, maybe just a sketch, or maybe even sing it to him and sometimes whistle it. And he'd quickly flesh it out into a fully orchestrated piece of music, usually within just a few hours, and most often his name never appeared on any of it. One of his closest friends and greatest clients was John Philip Sousa. So it's pretty certain we've all heard lots of Harry's music in some form or another, having written some 34,000 arrangements for all of his clients. But as well, he was a skilled composer, having written over 100 compositions under his own name, and he wrote for the University of Illinois Marching Band, one of the first to consider writing for a marching band during the 1920s, including stuff like The March of the Illini and The Glory of the Gridiron. He was a great friend of Glenn Cliff Bainham, the director of bands at Northwestern University. And in 1939, he wrote the great march, Purple Carnival, and dedicated it to Mr. Bainham. Please welcome conductor Mary Gingrich, the Prairie Brass Band, and Purple Carnival March.